Alright, so not too long ago, we took one GP in free to play and limited ourselves to only using the Varrock shops, and we saw how much money we could make in exactly 1 hour. Today, we're going to be doing the same thing, but we're going to be starting with zero GP, and we're going to be able to use every single shop in the game, meaning that we will be a member for the challenge. Now, some people may have argued that using one GP was too much of an advantage. Today, I've got you. We are literally going to be starting with zero GP, and I'm going to show you guys how you can make bank just using the shops, starting from absolutely nothing. For this challenge, we are going to be starting ourselves in the Tree Gnome Stronghold. And the reason we're starting here is because just upstairs to the west, there is a shop that has a secret kitchen cabinet that is going to start off this whole thing. Also, the first shop from Hudo is going to be the key to starting us off. The only cash I'll be using is, of course, the cash I make from buying items from the shops and selling it to the Grand Exchange. Now, a quick little concept I want to explain to you. In the food shop section here, there is a kitchen cabinet. And if we search it, you can literally spawn items. There is absolutely no limit on how many of these you can take. Now, I found a way to pretty much bring mass amounts of items from this cabinet into the game. All you have to do is click the cabinet, hold down the numbers 1, 2, 3, or 4 on your keyboard, and then just click the cabinet every tick or 0.6 seconds. It's really easy to do once you've got it down. We're only gonna have to use this cabinet one time. I'm pretty much just gonna get a full inventory of those trays. The timer has been started. We're gonna click on the kitchen cabinet, and all you have to do is hold down 2 on your keyboard and just click this every 0.6 seconds. And as you guys can see, it literally took us 25 seconds to get a full inventory. Come over to Hudo. We're gonna sell all the tins. We almost have 100 GP. And now we're just gonna buy some pineapples from the shop. The reason we're buying pineapples is because they go for an insane amount in the Grand Exchange. And as you guys can see from the shop, they only cost 2 coins. So we're gonna spend all of our GP buying pineapples. That is already one inventory of pineapples done. There's conveniently a banker over here. We're gonna go spend the rest on the last inventory. There we have it. We have 49 pineapples in the bank. We're gonna go ahead, note all of that. Now what we're gonna do is just home teleport to Lumbridge. As you guys can see, price checker is showing us 6.8K. If we get over 5,000, honestly, I'll be happy with that. All right, so it's 5 minutes, 30 seconds in. We've made it to the GE. How much will we get? 7.5K, more than we even expected on the pineapples. Now that we have the 7.5K, guys, we're gonna be buying a Falador teleport tab, and I'm gonna show you guys why in just a second. We're also gonna be picking up a Varrock teleport so that we can get back to the Grand Exchange. Now I'm gonna show you guys a super secret shop. Once you're in Falador, all you're gonna do is run southwest. As you guys can see, we're in the gem shop, and you guys might be wondering, why is this shop so good? My boy Herquin sells an uncut sapphire for 25 coins. He also sells a normal sapphire for 250. Now we just spent 275 coins, and how much are these worth? 1.4K. That is almost 6 times the money spent on the world. So we're just gonna start hopping to random members' worlds, and I'm gonna show you guys how effective this shop really is. Our inventory is now full. We still have 2.7K, which I wanna use up, so we're just gonna go ahead and run north and bank them. No, okay, so if you hop too many times, you will get put to the login screen, and you guys will be presented with the message, too many login attempts, please wait a few minutes before trying again. So I have a plan B where we don't actually have to hop that many worlds. Come over to Castle Wars using the mini game teleport. Anyone can do this. What we're gonna do is we're gonna bank the rest of the sapphires, and we're gonna head over to Yanil. Yanil is just east of this Castle Wars teleport, which is why we use it. We're gonna come over here to the beer shop, and I'm gonna show you guys why in just a second. So if you come to the bartender in the beer store, he sells a very specific kind of beer. It is called the Green Man's Ale. People use this to boost their farming level 1. And as you guys can see, it's a 616 GP. Now these do take like a couple seconds to buy, and they do cost 10 coins each. I'm gonna stay here until I've literally spent the rest of my cash. The beauty about these is that there is no limit on how many you can buy, and you don't have to hop worlds at all. There we go, inventory number 1's already done. We have 854 more GP. It's saying all of these are worth 16K. We only spent 260 GP. Inventory 2 done. All right, inventory 3 done. How many do we have? 78. All right, last one coming through. I'm about to be free. Yes, all right, use this Varrock teleport. Let's get over to the Grand Exchange. Take all these out, noted. First, we're just gonna dump the sapphires. That is a no-brainer. Those will always buy in the Grand Exchange. That's a nice 26K we already have. And now I'm gonna go ahead and sell one of these guys. see how much they go for. Oh, it actually sold at $783. Gonna dump as many as I can in for that price. Well, that is not what I wanted to see. Now, getting them at 616 would have made me happy. Oh, they actually all sold at 616. Easy. 90K, boys. That method was cancer, but it was worth it. All right, next line of business. We're going to buy another Varrock teleport. And what I'm going to do is head straight back to the Trinome Stronghold. Now, the reason I'm going back is because there's a specific shop that sells clue scroll requirement items. Now, the item I have my eye on is the pink robe top. So if we come over here to this guy named Rometto, as you guys can see, they go for 180 each. So we just spent around 1K and it's worth 2.6K for all of them. And there is a bank just east of here. We can also wear one to be efficient. Okay, I think I just went full Sherlock on this and found an item. The green hat goes for 160, but it is an item required for both medium and easy clue scrolls. So this one would have the highest demand. This is the item we're gonna go with. The pink robe, the pink rope top, and the green hat. The key to finding good items from the shops is finding items that people need to use and actually have some demand for on the Grand Exchange. All right, so that was about 5K spent. How much is the price checker gonna show us? No way, dude, that is so good. Plus I'm also wearing a green hat and a pink robe top. Straight into the tab. Let's see how fast we can burn that. It only takes 3 world hops, so you can imagine it's pretty quick. We are coming up to the 30 minute mark. I don't know how long I want to stand here because the final shop is going to make us the most money and you guys are going to see what it is. Kind of lost track what inventory this is, but I think I have a pretty good idea of how long we're going to stay here for until we've hit the 40 minute mark. By then we should have around 20K left. Finally, we're done buying these goddamn robes. So yeah, let's hope we don't get shafted here by the Grand Exchange. These should sell. I'm very confident in the green hats. So this is everything we've bought. I accidentally bought these pink hats. I'm gonna see if they can actually sell. Nice. Wow, those are actually good. They sold for 503 each. This is where I kind of get scared, guys. How many can we sell? Ooh, okay, so those sold for 591 each. How much will one pink rope top sell for? 510 each. If these all sell right now, I'll be so happy. Okay, about more than half of them sold. I'm actually not mad. And the hats can go for 591. I'm gonna put them down to 500 because I'm still happy with that profit. They all sold exactly 500 each. All right, no time to waste here, guys. We're gonna dump all of the pink rope tops. And the rest sold for 500 each. So half a K buying them for 180, 191K cash. This is where we go to the end game shop. And I'm gonna show you guys how we can get this up really quick. Now that we have a comfortable amount of, I've come over to pest control. You can do this again by using the minigame teleport. Been 30 minutes since the last time we've used it, so we can now use it again. I banked the one Varrock tab I bought from the Grand Exchange so that we can get back to Varrock. On this island, we'll find 3 shops here. As you guys can see, death runes fully in stock. This is what we wanted to see because these are gonna make us a whole lot of money. What we're gonna do is we're gonna use all of our money on the death runes inside the rune shop at Pest Control. Now, in this arrow shop here, I've just noticed that these arrow tips can actually all be bought out for profit. Because I'm getting the login screen error, we can actually also just alternate between the shops. So yeah, right after we buy the death runes, we'll just give this shop a visit, hop, buy out all these arrow tip, and repeat the process, I guess, until we have 0 GP cash. And I just thought of a really good idea. We're just gonna ditch this area after spending all of our time on the pest control island there. The arrow tips are actually selling. We've round 8 minutes on the clock. All right, guys, this is going to be the last shop we're gonna be doing. It is Nordak's Bone Weaponry Shop. This is a super secret shop, guys. If you've started Recipe for Disaster and you have the Lost Tribe done, you can literally just buy the bone weaponry. You can buy the bone weaponry and you're super close to a bank because the bank chest is right beside the cave. Now, the item that makes you the most profit here are the bone daggers. As you guys can see, we're buying them for 2K. And they go for 2.9 on the Grand Exchange. Also, the bone bolts go for a couple GP higher than you buy them for in the bolt packs. And the same follows for the Dorkshin crossbows. Let's take it all out of the bank. Wow, so the bows sold with absolutely no issue at 2.6K each. The bone daggers are in for 2.8. All right, onto the bone bolts. They sold at 5 each. All right, for the bone daggers, I'm going to put them in at 2.890 and they're not selling. Now, since we do have, you know, a couple minutes more, guys, we want to make the most profit possible. So we're just gonna leave the bone daggers in to slowly sell off. And what we're gonna do is just go buy as many more crossbows and bolts as we can, since those sold instantly. All right, we got about one more trip left in us, and then we will be done the hour. So this is gonna be the last world hop of the video because our inventory is now full. And you know, I'll try to get one more crossbow here by just equipping the bolts. There it is, boys. 1 hour. We started with zero GP on members, only using the shops. We've got 10,000 bolts and 49 bows that we need to put into the Grand Exchange. And we were also trying to sell our bone daggers. They're slowly coming through. People are buying them out. The crossbows had absolutely no problem last time, so we're just gonna throw them in. And as for the bolts, they do sell at 5 each. What's up, guys? So this is a couple hours later. I decided to step outside the house. I'm not really going to include the time it took to sold outside of the hour, but if we go ahead and collect 354k, I also have to extinguish the candle lantern and put it in the price because we did buy this 361,000 GP starting from absolutely nothing. Right before we cut into the outro, guys, I just want to give a huge shout out to the channel sponsor, Tayrock. They make amazingly good looking watches. The model TXM087 is being shown on the screen now. All their popular models just got restocked on their site. Be sure to head over. The link is in the description and you can use code CHALLENGE for 20% off. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to slap the like button. If you have any more 1 hour suggestions, guys, please leave them in the comments below. And if you guys have not subscribed to the channel already, make sure you subscribe. You will get 30 days from a clue, guaranteed. A good thing to remember is that if you try to do the exact same shops I did, you might not be as successful now because of this video being released. A lot of people are gonna try to do exactly what I did. Try to find your own shops because there are so many in the game that I didn't actually cover, and there is so much bank to be made, especially if you have shops that are blocked by quests and total level worlds. Much more to say on that. And on that note, we are going to be ending the video here, boys. Until next time, have a great day.